Wherever you are watching me from all over the world, I wish you compliments of the season. You are welcome back to my channel. If you are seeing me for the very first time, my name is C Concept. Thank you for tuning in. And I want to say a massive thank you for your love toward this channel. Thank you for your support. I'm very, very grateful. Without much talk, today I shall be showing you how to make this beautiful ball circle dress on your screen, but our main focus will be the down part, which is the skirt. Okay, I'll be showing you how to measure it on my pattern paper. I'll be showing you how to cut it and how to stitch it. So if you want to see it from the start to finish, I will implore you to sit back as we move on to the working table. Thank you. To start this tutorial, I will place my pattern paper on fold like this. And if you are using your fabric, same thing, you place it on fold. After that, I went ahead and I marked out my zipper allowance, and that is 1.5 inches. This is it. From the folded edge here, I went in by 1.5 inches. Length of the dress is 60 inches. That is, from the shoulder line to the down part is 60 inches. While the half length, that is the measurement from the shoulder line to the waistline, is 17 inches. 60 inches minus 17 inches, that will be 43 inches. Okay, so the total skirt for the down part will be 43 inches. But what I normally do for this type of a dress is I always add 2 inches extra to the allowance. Half an inch on the upper part to join it to the half length, and 1.5 inches on the down parts. As we proceed, I will tell you the reason. So the next thing again is to determine the panels. If you look closely at the picture, you see the skirt as a panel. For this tutorial, I'll be having 10 panels. Okay, right, I haven't determined the panels for this skirt, which is 10 panels. This is it. So this is what I mean. As you can see here, I have 5 here. Okay, this is the front skirt. So 5 for the front, 5 for the back. Friends, the waist circumference for this skirt is 30 inches. So 30 inches divided by 10, that will be 3 inches. Okay, I cannot just place this 3 inches like this, because if I place it while my paper is on fold, when I spread it out, that will be 6 inches. Right. So what I will do, I will go ahead and divide this 3 inches by 2 again. That will be 1.5. That is 1.5 inches. So on my paper here, from this zipper line, I will go in by 1.5 inches. But remember, we are still going to join it on both sides. So I'll be adding 1/2 inch to here. That will be 1.5 plus 1/2 inch, making a 2 inches. All together for this waistline, I will place 2 inches. From this line, I'll go in by 2 inches. This is it. Okay, 2 inches. For the down parts, depends on how wide you want the down parts to be. Okay, for my client, she doesn't want it too wide. In that case, I'll be going in by 8 inches. It's not constant. You could make yours 10 inches, you could make yours 9 inches, you could make yours 7 inches. It depends. From this zipper line, I will move in by 8 inches. 8 inches plus 1/2 inch to join it to both sides. That will be 8.5 inches. This is it. 8.5 inches, which is somewhere here. Next thing is to connect the waistline, which is 2 inches I went in with, to the 8.5 inches on the down parts. Right, I'll go ahead and cut it out now. From the down parts, I'll take it like so. After cutting the pattern, this is how it's looking now. This is the down parts, and this is the upper parts. As you can see, I folded the zipper allowance in. So to cut it out now, I'll be cutting out 9 panels, okay? While the 10th one will be for the zipper. And to cut out the zipper, I will fold out this zipper allowance out like this. Place it on my fabric and cut it out. Okay, so let's go ahead and cut out the 9 panels first. So the first thing I'll do, I'll place my fabric the right side inside like so. This is the wrong side of the fabric. I've added all my allowance on the pattern paper. I'll place it, then secure it with my pins. Go ahead now and cut it out, like notching it. Like I said, I'll be cutting out 9 panels first. I've cut out the first one, so I have 8 panels left. I'll go and cut that out, then come back to show you how to cut the zipper panel. To cut out the zipper panel, I've folded out the zipper allowance. As you can see now, this is it, spread out. So I've placed my fabric on fold as well, place it. I've cut out 9 panels already, so plus this, making 10. I'll go ahead and cut it. This is what I have now for the zipper panel. So I will slit this part open. Now it makes it 10 panels. For the back panel now, I have 6 panels. After placing the zipper, I will have it 10 panels altogether. One more thing, I will mark out my zipper allowance and notch it 1.5 inches. Is it? Also for the damp parts, 1.5 inches notch. This will guide me to place it properly when stitching it. So this is it after cutting it. I've also added my interfacing on it, including the lining. I've also cut it out. So the next thing now is to stitch it together. Okay, and I'll be taking you guys along with me as I stitch it. To stitch it, the first thing I'll be doing, I will take the lining first, because I'll be adding a crinoline to the damp part of the skirt. This is my crinoline, and this is 1.5 inches by height. So what I will do, I will place my crinoline on it like this, and then leave 1/2 inch away to the damp part of the lining. Secure it with my pin. Having done pinning it, I will take it to my sewing machine. Then, close to the edge, I will run my stitch on it. On the crinoline, I will run my stitch on it until I get to the other edge. Okay. After stitching it, I will now place it on the main fabric, right side facing each other. This is it after stitching it. So I'll go ahead and place it on the main fabric. This is the right side. Place it like so, center to center. I've notched the midpoint of the lining, also the main fabric, center to center. Then take it to my sewing machine, close to the edge, not on the crinoline this time around. Let me use my scissors. Close to the edge on the fabric, okay, close to the edge of the crinoline, but not on the crinoline. I will run my stitch down to this edge. Right, I've joined the main fabric and the lining together. This is the wrong side and this is the right side. Okay, you see how it's looking now. This is how the damp part will look like, very neat and tidy. Okay, so I'll go ahead and do one more of this type, then come back to show you how to join the panels together. So I have 2 panels now. This is the right side, this is the wrong side, as you can see. So I'll go ahead and iron it properly. After that, I will now take both sides like this, seam line to seam line. I will turn it like this, right side facing each other, main fabric on main fabric, lining on lining. This method, if you don't have overlocking machine, is very good. Okay, make sure the seam line are on the same line, then secure it with my pin. To stitch it now, I will take it from one side. You see that I take it from the side that has a main fabric or from the side that has lining. Okay, so that's how we take it from the middle, from this damp part. I will take it up, I will take it to the upper part, then when I'm done, I will change it again, then take the lining part to the upper part. So I will do that, then show you the next
two panels together. As you can see, this is the lining,
this is main fabric. Let me show you inside. So this is how it's looking inside. Use this to cover the main fabric and iron it properly. Then I'll have something like this after ironing it. If you don't have overlocking machine, no cause for alarm. Don't worry, nothing to worry about.